rather than attacking the U.S. homeland directly, let us go and bring down the Islamic countries in the Middle East and North Africa so that we can reestablish an Islamic caliphate that would stretch from Iraq and Iran the whole way to Syria, through Syria into the North Africa, into Morocco as well. And in doing that, establish such a power base that we can then influence world events and eventually control these countries that we want to control. So supporting the Muslim Brotherhood really became a critical error. They masked themselves using smoke and mirrors as a revolutionary democratic movement, but they were being controlled by Al-Qaeda.
I've got a couple more questions. Why and who in our government is involved? Why and who?
Well, you know, okay, it's an interesting question. And what I'd like to say is, you know, the overall situation that we as a nation face today, and in fact the world faces today, rises above the politicians and the political parties that they're made of, even in our own nation. There are politicians in power right now in our country who are merely puppets of this banking cartel. What we as a nation need to do is understand that one level above all of them in this banking cartel is where the real problem exists, which is what needs to be dealt with. But to answer your question, when you look at the Muslim Brotherhood as a recent situation that is widely talked about in the media, what you don't hear about in the media is who the Muslim Brotherhood really is and the deep roots that it actually has right into the White House and into the State Department. Now, it may not surprise you, a lot of people are aware of this, that the Deputy Chief of Staff to Hillary Clinton is in fact tied to the Muslim Brotherhood. There are lots of allegations of individuals who are advisors in the White House working for Obama who are in fact Muslim Brotherhood. So let's talk about briefly, who is the Muslim Brotherhood? The Muslim Brotherhood was established in 1928 by a gentleman named Hassan al-Banna, who established the organization based upon the ideology of the Nazis. His main idol that he publicly admitted to in the 1930s was Adolf Hitler. So their guise of Islam is really Islamic fascism. From that period forward, the Muslim Brotherhood has spawned many terrorist actions directed towards, you know, Christians, towards Jews, towards dictators, and any governments that oppose their fascist principles. The Hamas in 1987 was born out of the Muslim Brotherhood. Many of Al-Qaeda's senior operatives, including Sheikh Khalid Mohammed, the mastermind of 9/11, was a member of the Muslim Brotherhood. So with that, I'll leave you with a very brief quote. In 2004, the Kuwaiti Minister of Education, Dr. Ahmed Al-Raba, said, "The beginnings of all religious terrorism that we are witnessing today were in the Muslim Brotherhood ideology, and those who worked with bin Laden and Al-Qaeda went under the mandate of the Muslim Brotherhood." I think that speaks for it all. So you have to ask yourself, is the Arab Spring really an Arab Spring, or are the principles of freedom and democracy that many Muslims truly do want being co-opted by extremists and Al-Qaeda? And why would the banking cartel support and be aligned with these efforts? Is it about creating so much global chaos that it does in fact destroy the institutions that our ancestors fought and died for, the freedoms that we currently have that are under threat today? Is it in fact to destroy all of that and our Constitution and Bill of Rights to bring about their new world order?
And in doing it, the chaos drives up the price of oil. The price of oil then starts to bankrupt countries, and then countries have to do something with their sovereign debt. The banking cartel then buys the sovereign debt. They then control the countries, and when their time is right, when they want to, they crash the currencies and basically impose their new world currency, which then leads them to their goal of a new world order. And it almost seems too frightening to be true.
I hope you'll get this book, and I hope you'll open your mind to the possibility of what's happening around the world and to our country in particular. One final note. You talk about the 1/10,000th of a percent or something of that nature.
Well, we had heard a lot during the political campaigns about the one percenters, the 99 percenters. Now I guess it's 53-47, the percent. But what we've looked at is that the top 1% is not the problem. It's the top 1/10,000th of 1%, the people who are truly the elites, who are aligned, who are doing this. Not all bankers, your local banker, is not necessarily evil. But the people who are at the very top are evil. And they need to be exposed, and then hearkening back to our own Constitution, they need to be arrested, tried, convicted, and pulled from power. And the only way to do that is to spread the word, to enlighten people, to let them know what's happening, because these people truly operate behind smoke and mirrors. They can't stand to be exposed. And so we have to do that. They are criminals. They need to be apprehended. They need to be tried, convicted, and punished.
There's one more thing in here. It goes a little bit deeper. When you say evil, how evil? What are we talking about?
Well, you know, again, I mean, going back to my research and to a very senior member within the banking cartel himself, who's recently become a born-again Christian, these people at the very top of the pyramid, let's say, are in fact Satanists, and they do in fact worship a different god than all of us, no matter what your religion, and that is Lucifer. And they do practice satanic worship. I know it's a shocking thing to imagine, but it's very real, ladies and gentlemen, and this is really happening.
You should connect the dots. Start with this book, www.smokeandmirrorsthebook.com. I hope you'll read it. Thank you.